Hey, what's up, guys? Growing the Hobby coming back to you guys with another break. Our final SPA week break. That is right. We are going to do the brand new, new-ish. I guess we're kind of, you know, a little over a week here into the release. But Hobby Box of 2021 SP Authentic Hockey. That's right. Some good stuff. Hopefully to come out of that today. I threw up the big boys there in the background. You guys can see on either side. I'm hoping that they bring us a little bit of luck here as we conclude out this week. Also, before we begin our break, real quick today, guys, I actually got a package in the mail a couple days ago from Upper Deck. I already opened it, as you guys can see, but I thought I would show everybody here on camera what I got. I think this was actually for the Chris Kreider, what was it, rookie auto that I pulled out of, like, SPX or something like that. It was an expired redemption. Upper Deck does the expired redemption program. You can turn that in. They enter you into an entry, like for, you know, a drawing and stuff that they pull every month, and you can win a really nice card. And at the very least, they try to send you some type of card if you don't win the prize. But this month, I actually, as you guys can see right there, how about that? I was a winning entry this time. So we got a card from the raffle. You know, I will give Upper Deck props for the old expired redemptions there. They do their best, you know, to kind of honor it. They're much better than Panini, that is for sure. And the card that I got, guys, they sent me one card, and this was it. How about that? A pretty cool signature materials from the Cup, my favorite product other than SPA. But obviously ultra high-end there. 42 of 99 of Bob, Sergei Bobrovsky there while he was still with the Blue Jackets before moving on to the Panthers. But love my Cup cards and a pretty sick patch right there in the center to go with everything else. So, and that is from 17-18, the Cup, if anybody was wondering there. So nice little card there from Upper Deck. Definitely appreciate that. For sure, and I thought that was kind of cool. I want to show you guys that as we conclude out this week. But yeah, let's get on to the main show. That is this box right here, 2021 SPA. I'm going to cut the cellophane out of the way, and I'll show you guys the odds on the back of this. This is my first opening of this year, both on or off camera. Ultra pricey price point right now. Probably going to wait for this to die way down. I think the prices will come down on this here eventually. I feel like I'm one of the ones that got absolutely screwed here because I didn't pre-order this like a year ago or anything. I waited for Dave and Adams to actually list it up on their website for pre-orders and stuff like that. I'll show you guys the odds as I'm talking here. But I waited for them to list it on their website to pre-order because normally they hook me up with a pretty good price. I kind of got screwed this time though because my pre-order price that I paid was like $400 per box, which was absolute insanity. You know, these, I was buying an inner case of these for of, you know, 1920 SPA for all of, oh man, what was I paying, about $800 a box or something, so for that inner case, so, you know, $100 a box on average, just insanity and stuff like that, you know, and not to mention that they took out the Young Gun updates and Upper Deck updates out of here this year, so, because due to extended series, so, yeah, it's a little bit lackluster, I think. You know the big boys by now, guys. It's Kirill the Thrill. That's who I'm looking for mainly if I'm looking for a future watch. Two and three in no particular order. You got Stutzla and Lafreniere. Those are both big ones. I mean, there's plenty of other big ones. You guys know the usual suspects by now. This is not this year. This is 2021, so last year's crop. And for me, I'm looking for a big, you know, sign of the times auto would be nice. You know, or a limited auto of a big name. That would actually be pretty cool with me and stuff. So 18 packs per box. Five cards per pack, the same kind of lineup as years past. I'll show you guys. I'll kind of slow down on the first pack here, and then we'll speed a little bit up through the rest of the packs here and stuff, because I'm sure you guys have seen this by now. I've seen a lot of breaks of this and stuff so far. We're going to be getting our limited red parallels inserted throughout these boxes. They have six decoys, not including if you pull like a patch card or something like that, but six decoys, so we'll have six thicker packs, which is what they did in 1920. That was kind of the first year that they did that, as opposed to like 1819, where you had a thick decoy in every pack. And this pack does not have a decoy. We'll be getting one Future Watch in here, hopefully. One Future Watch auto and one other auto. That seems to be the average, so two autos. I've seen some people skunked with no autos whatsoever, and I've seen some people getting some loaded boxes, but for the most part, that is what I've seen. And here is our design this year. We'll kind of go slow here on this first, you know, card and pack here with Alex Tuck. Nice design this year. I actually like it. It's pretty cool. Little bit of retro feel to it, in my opinion, stuff like that, but pretty cool. We're going to be seeing a lot of retro cards in here as well that we'll pull out of here, so we'll get to that here momentarily. first pack here, I think it's going to be, this is going to be a retro card right off the bat. So right behind Leon Draisaitl. We got Mika Zibanejad. There's going to be our retro look here for the year. Show you guys the back of one of those retros. And, we're going to be getting a few of these here per box. I can't remember the exact number, but I anticipate probably another three or so of those. John Klingberg, and last but not least, Zach Werenski. And I haven't decided if I'm going to be kind of hostile here, if I can see the Future Watch coming or something like that, or if I know an auto is coming, I might hold it to the end. I'm not sure if I want to do that or not. This is such a high-risk, opening here and stuff, with at least with the price point that I paid, this $400 per box is just ludicrous. I mean, it's absolute insanity. It's this and the Cup are my favorite product, but my gosh, they are absolutely pricing us out of that anymore. I mean, this, what I paid for this box is more than I was paying for a box of the Cup, you know, about a year and a half ago or so. It's just insane. But Yanni Gourde starts us off here. Brendan Gallagher behind the we got a Future Watch. Is that going to be an auto one? That might, I think it's going to be an auto. Yep, that's an autograph Future Watch right off the bat. I am going to be a little bit hostile, guys. I've decided I'm going to hold that. Set that right on top of Bob for a little bit of luck, I hope. We're going to save that one for the end because that's our kind of guaranteed autograph Future Watch of the box. So I might just show you guys the other auto as we come to it and put all the marbles kind of in one basket here with that Future Watch auto, but we'll see. Victor Hedman, Matt Zuccarello. I think we have another retro. We do, of Dominic Kubalik. There you go with the Blackhawks. They're just absolutely overhauling their team, it seems, here. Just having a fire sale, more or less. Matt Murray and Miro Heiskanen. Thick pack here, so it's probably going to be a decoy. I might actually peek to see if it's a decoy. Oh, my Lanta. Oh, heck yeah, guys. We had a patch auto. We had a patch auto. Let's hope it's a Future Watch patch auto. It could be a limited patch auto. Either way, that is going to be a case hit. An inner case hit, that is, guys. So one in every eight, roughly, on those. That is some luck to pull from a loose box, because if you guys are wondering how I know that, this is what the... Here, let me get this pack a little bit out of the way. I'll show you guys a little bit more. This is what I'm looking at here. That is a... Get that to clear up maybe a little bit if I can get that. There you go. That is what a standard decoy looks like. That is absolutely a patch auto that we got. Wow. That is serious, serious luck, guys. Serious, serious luck. All right, so Carey Price starts us off here. Jordan Staal, a Celebrated Moments. Our first one of those that we're going to pull here. It's going to be a Braden Point. Very, very nice. Good stuff there. So hopefully we are going to end. This is, by the way, what their decoys look like this year. They're giving themselves a little bit of social media plugs and stuff like that, as opposed to just putting the kind of blank filler card in, Braden Point and JVR. But it looks like hopefully we will be ending this week here on a bang, because we got a Future Watch auto for sure and a limited patch auto or a Future Watch patch auto pending here for us. So RNH, Anders Lee, and Leaders card, True Leaders of Anze Kopitar. So that's what, it's kind of a newer design here and stuff like that for this year. First True Leaders card. We'll get a couple of those here in this break. Shake and Bake Gensel and Tyson Berry. So, wowie, I'm pretty stoked that we actually got a Future Watch or a patch auto coming up here. Can't say Future Watch because I don't know that it's going to be that. Braden Schenn, Austin Matthews, and we got our first red. That's what that looks like this year. It's actually pretty cool, in my opinion. Keith Yandel. So, limited red. That's what that looks like this year. Pretty cool. I mean, compare it right there to the basic design. I like it. Patty Kane and Nico Hischier. So, you know, some serious luck here. You know, the big question is going to be, who are the two autos going to be? I mean, we are talking big, big money if you get the right guys in either of those, really. I mean, if we get a Kirill the Thrill, which would just be absolute insanity, you know, we're talking some serious money right now. I think it's overpriced. Hey, there's a heck of a guy right there, recent Stanley Cup champ. Big-time player there, Kel McCarr. Nice card to pull. Drin and Sebastian Aho. But yeah, I mean, you're talking some serious, serious money with a player like Kirill the Thrill if you get him in the patch auto or the basic Future Watch. You know, like I said, I do think they're a little bit priced insanely right now, but that would be a heck of a nice pull. Keith Yandel, Martin Jones, another red. Eric Staal. So we're nailing the reds here all in a row. Jonathan Huberdeau and Ryan Suter. Definitely want to open more of this stuff, guys, but I'm probably going to be waiting for a little bit to the price to go down here. Mac Daddy right there. Seth Jones, another retro. Anders Lee. And then we got Quinn Hughes behind there and Brady Tkachuk. But, yeah, I really, really wish that I could have bought at least an inner case this year. But, I mean, that's just – I'm sorry, guys. For the price point that I paid, it's just insane. Going to wait for it to come down and hope to pick up an inner here at some point. But when the price comes way down – Natty Mac, another Stanley Cup champ there, David Perron, and then we got a Leaders of Patrice Bergeron again. Stammer and Ryan O'Reilly. Getting a little nervous here and feeling the tension kind of building from within. Those pending autos that we're going to check out here. Kyle Connor, Nick Suzuki, and another retro, Nick Schmaltz. Andrei Kopitar and Nikita Kucherov. We are getting down towards the bottom of the box. So moment of truth here very soon. And you never know, you might actually, you know, we could still pull another auto out of here. I've seen it. Like I said, it's just, on average, I've seen two autos coming out of these boxes, it seems. Elias, Patrice Bergeron, another retro. Igor, that's a nice one. Igor Shesterkin. Couldn't stand him when he played against my Pens, and I love taunting him. Check out the other videos on here. Nice to sit the kid there. But check out the other... The video here of my playoff game that I uploaded and stuff, if you guys want to hear how we taunted him and stuff. Nothing personal, Rangers fans and stuff. You guys understand with the playoffs. But he is a heck of a player. I will give him that. All right, Jumpin' Jack Hughes, Dominic Kubalik, and we got another True Leaders of Brent Burns. Big old filler, Zach Parise, and Sean Monahan. Another filler going to be in this pack for sure. And Andrei Svechnikov starts us off. We got our Spectrum effects coming up here behind Joe Pavelski. It's going to be a regular one of Tuukka, recently retired Tuukka Rask. You can get these in the future watches as well for some of the guys. I do not do that bounty program that's on the back, Thomas Hertl and Andrei Vasilevsky. All right, we are already down to our final three packs with the exception of those the two to hold autos for sure. Another thick pack here, so another decoy, Ryan Dzingel. Ryan Getzlaff. We got another moments, celebrated moments of Austin Matthews. Our Rocket Richard winner again. D-Boss and that jerk. All right, two packs to go. And then the big moment of truth. Big, big moment of truth. All right, another Spectrum effects. Hopefully, maybe it's a future watch on this one. Mitch Marner. Teuvo Teravainen, and it is level one, which is the lowest level, but still, let's check it. Hey, Matthias Brome, I'll take it. Anything on the wings is starting to get hot here. That's a team to keep your eyes on there. They got a lot of young and promising guys here, kind of flying under the radar a little bit still with their team overall. I do think they're going to break off very soon here, so that's a pretty cool one right there. I like that one. Johnny T and Roman Josi. All right, our last pack, and then we are going to unveil what we have lurking here. I'll probably show the Future Watch auto first, and then we'll do that patch at the end. And let's hope for something big. All right, Carter Hart. It's going to be another moment here. Barkov and Bowen Byram. So another recent Stanley Cup champ right there, Bowen Byram. Darcy Kemper and Cal Palmieri. All right, guys, so we are down to it. Here is the absolute moments of truth. Like I said, I'm going to go with the basic Future Watch auto first. I think that's right behind. Yeah, it is. It's behind Suzuki. So I'm going to pull from the back. Pasta. And we got Dylan Strome. And then our Future Watch auto for the box, barring that the patch is going to be a Future Watch auto patch. Which way are we going to go? Let's go like this. Come on. Let me see some wild colors. Capital One. I thought it said Capitals. It's Capital One is their sponsor, and it is going to be Philip Maillet. Philip Maillet. So that's a basic Future Watch right there. Oh my gosh, it's almost really hard to see. Like, look at that 8 and 9. A little bit of quality control issues there with the numbering and stuff like that, but you can kind of see like that. I guess it's supposed to be 338 of 999. Philip Maillet. This is where our Future Watch autos look like here this year, if you guys want to check out the back right there. But there you go, Caps fans. Philip Maillet, not terrible, but definitely not the guy that I'm looking for. We're all banking our marbles on that this other pack that's sitting here. We got a patch auto. Now, the moment of truth, whether it is a Future Watch patch auto or is it going to be a limited patch auto, either way, it's a victory. I mean, it's a heck of a pull, no matter who we actually pull out of here. To pull that from one loose box, like I said, that is a 1 in 8 chance of pulling one of those because that is an inner case hit. Should be the third one down here, so it should be safe to pull this. Yep. Johnny Gibson, Victor Olofsson. I'm going to pull from the bottom. Ovi. That could be a nice sign, hopefully. Patches, and here we go, guys. It's going to go from the side. I just don't know which specific side. I'm going to chance it and go this way to start. Nope. Auto's at the bottom. So we had that completely the opposite way. All right, moment of truth, guys. Moment of truth. Pull it in nice and close. Let's cross our fingers. And it is going to be... It is a Future Watch auto patch. So this will be out of 100. This could be insane, guys. Give me one of the big three or expand it. You know, my gosh, give me Ilya Sorokin even. That would be insane, too. A couple other big guys we're looking for, but oh, my gosh. Here we go, guys. What is it? Oh, it's a Canadian, right? Yep, unless I'm seeing things. It is a Canadian. It is going to be Alex Belzile. I have hit on him so much this year. I have just an insane collection of him. I mean, I will take it all day long. It's not the exact guy that I'm looking for, but pretty cool hit nonetheless. Nice two-color patch there. That is going to be, it's not jersey number or anything, but it is 48 out of 100. Still, I will take that all day long. That is a tough pull. And give that a little rub. Oh, yeah, very nice, very nice. So not a bad way to end the week. I will take it, guys. It might not be specifically the exact guys I'm looking for. But that is a tough hit, and, you know, let's be honest, we did pretty good for a loose box, you know, one loose box, you know, to hit on our guaranteed Future Watch auto, and then to hit a Future Watch auto patch, you know, out of 100, that is some pretty good luck. Definitely the two big hits of the box, for sure. Our other one that I'm going to highlight here real quick for you guys, it's not autoed, but, our other Future Watch, it's a Spectrum one, of Matthias Brohm, so, you know, not a bad box, guys, not a bad box. Did I get my $400 back? Absolutely not. But still, it was a fun one. I hope to do a lot more of this still in the future for sure. Like I said, I hope to get at least an inner of this. Just going to kind of wait out the prices here a little bit and stuff. But not a bad way to wrap the week up. I hope you guys enjoyed this week. I love me my SPA. I absolutely love it. That and the cup are definitely my favorite products here in hockey. And as you guys know, hockey is my favorite sport for sure. But yeah, a fun one for sure this week. I love doing this stuff, guys. I hope you all enjoyed it. Like I said, please do me a favor if you'd be so kind. Like, subscribe, share, click that bell notification button to be notified of future videos. Lots more of them coming to you guys. As always, in the description below, you can find my email address, mailing address, and Instagram handle. Other than that, have a great day, a great night, wherever y'all are at, and we will see you next time.